a new and very interesting but little complicated topic, that is your oogenesis, from the chapter Human Reproduction. Now children, what is oogenesis? Oogenesis means that it is a process of formation of female gametes, which we call it as ovum or egg, is called as oogenesis. Children, similarly here, like spermatogenesis, gametes are being formed in the females. Because for the fertilization process, sperms as well as ovum both are needed. So the formation of sperm, spermatogenesis, we have discussed in the last video, and today we will be discussing about the formation of ovum, about the formation of egg, which is called as female gamete. Now the process oogenesis is made up of two terms. Now the two terms are oo and genesis. The term oo means egg, and genesis you are knowing now, to produce something, to synthesize something, to generate something. So the process in which the eggs are being generated, the process in which the ovum, the female gamete, is being processed, is being produced, is called as oogenesis. Now there is another term mentioned on the board, oocytogenesis. Oocytogenesis is again a process which is taking place in the process of oogenesis. So what it is? It is the process of formation of primary oocyte, is called oocytogenesis. Children, the difference between oogenesis and oocytogenesis is that oogenesis is a complete process of egg formation, of ovum formation, and oocytogenesis is a part of process of oogenesis in which your primary oocyte is being produced. Now you might be thinking that what is primary oocyte? We will be discussing each and every point in detail in the coming up session of this video. Now this process occurs in female ovaries, in female gonads. This is clear to you all, you are knowing it very fine, that your spermatogenesis occurs in the testis, which is a male gonad, which is a male reproductive organ. Similarly here in the females also, the female reproductive system, the female main gonad is ovary, and within the ovary your whole oogenesis process is going to be completed. So the process occurs in the female ovaries, in the female reproductive system. Now we have discussed in the last video while studying during spermatogenesis that the whole gametogenesis process or the whole spermatogenesis process is completed in three phases, and those three phases were multiplication phase, growth phase and maturation phase. Similarly here also, in the process of oogenesis there are three phases called as multiplication phase, growth phase and maturation phase. These are the three phases which occurs, which is completed during the whole oogenesis process, during gradually passing through these all steps, all these phases, your ovum production is taking place, your ovum is being formed. Now one by one, slowly we will be discussing each and every phases along with the whole process. Children, I have told you all that learning the line diagram, learning the diagrams and learning the names of the parts makes the learning of biology very easy. So now in the beginning I will be explaining in brief that what happens during the multiplication phase, growth phase and maturation phase. Then I will be moving to the line diagram, then I will be moving to the diagrammatic part and the explanation of the whole oogenesis process. Now let us, children, move with the three phases, and on the board I have mentioned the first phase, the multiplication phase. Now what is this multiplication phase saying? In this multiplication phase, inside the ovary of fetus, some cells of germinal epithelium are bigger in size and are called as oogonium or egg mother cell. Now children, here are many terms which are very important to understand. Now you can see that I have written inside the ovary of fetus. Now what is fetus? Fetus is the developing child inside the mother's womb, inside the uterus. Now in the structure of uterus, you have studied that this was a type of structure of a mother's womb, of a uterus. Now this was the endometrium line, and suppose this whole structure is the mother's womb. This is mother's womb. Now inside this mother's womb, the fetus is developing. The developing child is developing. This is your fetus. And this is your uterus. And during the pregnancy time, where the child develops, is called as mother's womb. Children, if this developing fetus is a girl child, it is a girl fetus, the journey of the development of the ovum or egg starts long back before the birth of the girl child. When the girl fetus is during the embryonic stages, when the embryonic development of the fetus is going inside the mother's body, inside the mother's womb, during that time only the development, the process of oogenesis starts in the girl female, in the female fetus. It's a long journey before, which starts before the birth from the embryonic development stage and ends throughout the life when the menopause occurs. So your development of oogenesis, always remember that it doesn't start from the menarche and the menopause, but the development of the oogenesis, the development of the ovum, the development of the egg cells starts long before in the girl child, before their birth only, when the girl fetus is in the embryonic development stage inside the mother's womb. So I am talking about that stage. This multiplication phase is a phase where your, which is occurring during the developmental stage of the fetus inside the mother's womb. So during that time, children, inside the ovary of fetus, some cells of germinal epithelium. Now during that time, the ovary of the fetus, now the girl child has not taken birth, but the body developmental structure has started inside the girl child, inside the female child, in the mother's womb. Now during that time, the ovary which is developing inside the fetus, I am talking about that ovary. During that time, the ovary is having its germinal epithelium layering. If children, I draw the diagram of an ovary. Now this is a diagram of an ovary where inside the fetus, inside the mother's womb, developing fetus inside the mother's womb. Now here, this inner lining, the ovary inner lining is present, and this inner lining is made up of germinal epithelium. Why germinal? Because they are responsible for the formation of gametes. Now this germinal epithelium is only responsible for the formation of egg cell or ovum. Hence your germinal epithelium is present in the inner wall, in the inner lining of the ovary. Of whose ovary? Of the fetus ovary. And where is the fetus present? Fetus is present inside the mother's womb. So long before, during the embryonic developmental stages, when the fetus is getting developed, during that time only, inside the ovary of the fetus, this germinal epithelium lining gets ready to produce the cells. Now, germinal epithelium. Now, this germinal epithelium is having cells. They are having cells in it. So, some of the cells of this germinal epithelium lining becomes very big. They become big in size. Some of the cells, they become big in size. Not all cells, but some of the cells of this germinal epithelium lining, they grow in size, they develop in size, and they may be bigger. They are larger. So these bigger cells are called as oogonia. These bigger cells are called as oogonia, or they are also called as egg mother cell. So, some of the cells, when this germinal epithelium lining is developing inside the ovary, so these are cellular layer and many cells are being produced, and some of the cells by themselves, they proceed and they grow in size, they become bigger. And they start behaving like egg mother cell, mother of the egg cell. They start behaving like egg mother cell. And the other name for the egg mother cell is oogonia. So many oogonia cells are being produced inside the ovary of the fetus, inside the mother's womb. So during your multiplication phase, this process occurs, and this multiplication phase occurs long back, long prior to the female child birth. Now, in the multiplication phase, I'll repeat that inside the ovary of the fetus, many germinal cells, epithelium cells, they start behaving, they grow, and they start behaving like mother egg cell, and these mother egg cells are called as oogonia. Many cells, unlimited cells, many cells are formed. Now these oogonia cells will proceed again forward to the next phase, that is called as growth phase. Now children, moving to the next phase, that is your growth phase. Now growth phase occurs after the multiplication phase. Now during the multiplication phase, I told you all that your cells are developed and mother egg cell is developing over there. Oogonia is being formed. Now, that oogonia which is produced during the multiplication phase is carried forward to the growth phase. Now, this oogonium develops into primary oocyte. So these oogonium cells, these egg mother cells here, there are multiple number of cells. So these egg mother cells, these oogonium cells will develop, they will differentiate, and they will be changing into primary oocyte. So oogonium develops into primary oocyte. Now each primary oocyte gets surrounded by granulosa cells. There are special type of cells present inside the ovary, or waste type of cells which are present over here inside the ovary. Those granulosa cells, they get surrounded around the primary oocyte to form primary follicle. So primary follicle is being produced after the primary oocyte. Now children, here I have mentioned that this primary oocyte stage remains inside the body for many years. You will be understanding this point during the explanation of the whole oogonium process of the, sorry, during the whole oogenesis process. Now, what is primary oocyte? Now, this mother egg cell, this oogonium cell inside the ovary of the fetus, they will develop, they will differentiate, they will grow, and this oogonium cell will change into, they will change into primary oocyte. They will change into primary oocyte. Now, this primary oocyte will be changing into primary follicle. How? By the surrounding of granulosa cells. Now, children, inside the fetus of ovary, many cells are present. Normal cells are present inside. And these normal cells are called as granulosa cells. They are called as granulosa cells. These granulosa cells, they get engulfed around the primary oocyte. They get surrounded. It means that oogonium developing into primary oocyte, this primary oocyte will be surrounded by this granulosa cells. And these, after the surrounding, the structure which is formed, that structure is called as primary follicle. Children, there is nothing to worry. The process is a little complicated. But slowly, slowly, with the help of diagram and the line diagram, I'll be explaining everything. I'll try my best to explain it and to make it very easy to you all to understand. Now, this oogonium is changing into primary oocyte, and primary oocyte is getting surrounded by the normal granulosa cells, and the, now the structure is called as primary follicle. So this changes takes place during the growth phase. Growth phase is a very long phase. This primary oocyte development inside the female fetus, it remains for many years. Many years, it means till the girls attain puberty. This whole process, children, is starting in the girl child before the birth, during the development of fetus. But this primary oocyte stage remains inside the body of a female girl child even after the birth and till when? Till the girls attain the puberty. So, it is not a very short period. Now, before the development of a girl child, 9-month pregnancy period, the mother is holding. During that time, these changes are starting. And then, the girl child takes birth. And after the birth, and in between puberty, about 12 to 13 years difference is there. So many years difference. So this primary oocyte or this growth phase stage which is over here I'm talking about, that remains inside the body of a female till such a long period. That what? It means that primary oocyte stage remains inside the body for many years. Now children, after the growth phase, the next phase will be maturation phase. Now children, moving to the last part of the phases, that is your maturation phase. Now, in the maturation phase, the primary follicles which have been formed, that primary follicle will be changing. Now children, I forgot to say that during the growth phase, during that such a long years inside the body of the female girl, that primary follicles will be developing into secondary follicle, tertiary follicle, all such changes will be taking place. And after that, slowly, slowly, the next phase will start, that is your maturation phase. And during this maturation phase, like spermatogenesis only, even here, your meiotic division will take place. Meiotic division first and the meiotic division second. Both the divisions will carry forward, and that primary oocyte will be changing into secondary oocyte, and then finally your mature ovum will be formed, which will be ready for the fertilization process and for the formation of zygote. Now children, these were the three phases during the development of oogenesis, during the process of oogenesis. Now children, if I see what I have discussed till yet, I told you all that during your multiplication phase, egg mother cells are formed, oogonium cells are formed. Now this oogonium cells, during the growth phase, changes into primary oocyte. This primary oocyte gets surrounded by granulosa cells, and then the structure primary follicle is formed. And this primary follicle now enters into the maturation phase by entering the first and second meiotic division. Now children, if I move to explain it again with the help of diagram. So diagram representation is given over here. Now children, in the diagram, I have drawn the ovary of fetus inside mother's womb. Now this is the ovary. Inside the ovary, the inner lining is your germinal epithelium cells. Now from this germinal epithelium cells, many green color small oval structures you can see, these are oogonium. Now these oogonium is changing into primary oocyte after development, after divisions, after differentiation. And then this primary oocyte is surrounded by your granulosa cells. This blue color structure I have drawn, this is your granulosa cells. So this primary oocyte is surrounded by your granulosa cells, and the structure primary follicle is formed. So this was the complete structure which is now will be following into the second phase, that is your meiotic division, that is your maturation phase.